Hello everyone, welcome to SolveLancer, and through this video we are going to understand the guidelines for SolveLancer Quality Inspector. The content which we are going to follow will be, the first point will be role and main responsibility of Quality Inspector. Second will be the standard for quality check, in which we will see the conceptual and content part and format part. Third will be the requirements for rejections. Then we will see the anti-fraud, internal check, landmines and complaints. And next we will see penalty, and next we will see frequently asked questions. So let's start with the first point, which is the main role and responsibilities. So as a freelancer quality inspector, you shall check the quality of solution on both format and concepts, pass and reject the solution based on standards provided, and provide feedback screenshot for rejected task. Report special issues to the admin at anti-fraud@solvelancer.com and WhatsApp at +91 6375430573. So this was the first point. Now the second will be the standards for quality check. To calculate or to understand the standard for quality check, here we have divided it into two parts. The first part is concept and content based. The policy which we are following here is no referring to the third party website, app or brand, no providing of unethical or personal information. Solution must be in English regardless of language of question stem. So even if question is in English or in other language, Hindi or in some other language, but answer must be in English language. So this is very important point which we have to follow. Next is correct and complete answer and explanation should be there, and solution method within syllabus. So it should be within required syllabus. If applicable, key steps shall not be missing, like given to find solution or explanation, final answer. But this is only applicable based on the question parameters. For example, if you'll see, like given to find solution and final answer is not required in subjective type questions. Here in subjective type question, like for example, if you are doing biology or chemistry questions, so there we will only write solution or explanation, and then the freelancers or then the content producer can write the answer. Now the MCQ and theoretical type, we don't have to write to find and given. We can write the solution and then answer, and then hence the correct answer is this. So this table is required, or this table is important to understand how the producer will write based on different questions, right? So we are only following this complete to find, given, solution and answer statement for numerical, subjective and MCQ type questions. This is for numerical questions only, not for any other type of questions. So this is strictly to be followed. Now only related solution shall be present. There should not be any irrelevant content in the solution part. So this is the very important role for quality inspector to check about this. Now if you'll go to the policy, there should be no referring to third party website, app or brand, no providing of unethical or personal information. Samples for policy, if you'll see few samples. So like here we are seeing there is a sample and the third party Doubtnut other company sample logo is there. So we have to reject this type of answer. Similarly, in this answer we have the solution which is the logo symbolizing to SnapSolve. So we have to reject this type of answers as well. So this logo should not be there. So we should keep all these things in mind. Now, if we can reject the answer providing of personal information, for example, if you'll see this answer here, the personal information James Jones is written, which is the name of any other person. So that's why we have to reject this answer. Now the content structure, here we have the solution must be in English. This I have already explained, regardless of the language of question stem, correct and complete answer and explanation, solution methods within syllabus, if applicable, key steps shall not be missing. This is important, like if applicable, because it is not applicable in each and every type of questions. Now related solutions shall be present, irrelevant content shall not be present. Okay, now we'll see the samples for content structure. We will go through some samples and then we will try to understand this as clear as possible. So reject solutions must be in English and Hindi solutions are not acceptable. Question stem can be in English or Hindi. So if we'll see this answer, here the answer is in Hindi. That's why we have to reject this type of answer. Now reject if there is no explanation. Like sometimes the freelancers or content producer are directly writing the answer. So we have to reject those type of answers. Similarly, reject final answer. If final answer is incomplete, in that case also we have to reject. The full option A answer is 2 should be shown. Here only option A is written. So in that case also we have to reject. Now reject final answer is incomplete. Like the full option B dash dash shall be written, which I have already explained. Hence correct option is B. And what is that correct option? It should be 0 or whatever it should be. It depends on the question. Reject only related solution shall be present. Irrelevant content shall not be present. For example, if you will see this question, here this question and this first answer is related to this question, but second answer is not at all related. So in this case, this part is not at all required. So we have to reject this type of answer. Now, if you will go to the part 2, which is the format part, here the format part we have divided it into layout. So in the layout, content is left aligned with vertical, uniform vertical spacing. Single diagram is right aligned. If there is only one diagram, then it will be right aligned. But if there is a multiple diagrams, like 2, 3, more than one diagrams, in that case, the diagram will be left aligned. We will see these examples in later stage. So solution is uniform in terms of handwriting, alignment and spacing. If you see the writing, typing and screenshot, we have specifically written this writing, typing and screenshot because all these categories of answer is accepted. So legible handwriting or electronically typed or screenshot solution, both acceptable. Content horizontally lined, that is all the lines must be parallel to each other. First letter of every line must be vertically aligned and no freehand drawing, must use rulers, compasses. No spelling mistakes or misuse of symbols, punctuation. No underlining, boxing or ticking in any parts of the solution. We should not make a box or we should not tick any part of the solution. So next we will see the scanning part. The solution is always in black and white mode. So content producer should not send or should not post answer in colored mode. So that's why we have the render feature in our app. They can use the render feature. They will click the photo and then apply the render feature. This feature will make all the answers in black and white mode category. There should be no visual distractions, such as stains, wrinkles, shades, overexposure, etc. And appropriate framed and positioned, no tilting, background exposure and fingers, etc. should be there in the answer part. Now, in the layout part, content is left aligned with uniform vertical spacing between the lines. Single diagram is right aligned and multiple diagrams are left aligned. Solution is uniform in terms of handwriting, alignment and spacing. If you will see some samples, here we will see this answer we have to accept because this is a single diagram and here it is right aligned and solution is left aligned. So content is left aligned and solution is right aligned. So we can pass this answer. Now, if we'll see the reject multiple diagrams right aligned. For example, in this question, if you'll see the solution part here, two images are there, first and second. Since this is a multiple images, so it should be left aligned. Like one image will be here and other image will be here. Right? Next, we'll see the writing, typing or screenshot, legible handwriting or electronically typed solutions or screenshot, both acceptable. Content horizontally aligned, that is all the lines must be parallel to each other. First letter of every line must be vertically aligned. No freehand drawing. Must use rulers and compass. So rulers and compass is required. Freehand drawing should not be there. Now, no spelling mistake or misuse of symbols, punctuations. no underlining, boxing or ticking in any parts of the solution. This I have already explained. If you will go further, we will see the samples for writing, typing or screenshot. So this sample is acceptable because this may be the typed solution or maybe the screenshot of the solution. So both types or both categories we have to accept if the answer is correct conceptually. Now reject unreadable handwriting. For example, in this case you cannot read the handwriting, so we have to reject this obviously. If we'll go to the next part, we have to reject the first letter of every line is not vertically aligned. That is, if you'll see here, there are many solutions and the producer has written in random haphazard manner. So this will be first solution, then second solution. This is not correctly aligned. So that's why we have to reject this type of answer. If you'll go to the next, which is reject freehand drawing. This I have already explained. This is a freehand drawing and because of this, it should be rejected. But appropriate reason of rejection is must. Now reject boxing and underlining. So here, if you'll see this T equal to 50 divided by 3 N Newton. So this is inside the box and so we have to reject this. Similarly, this part inside the box, we have to reject this. If you'll see the scanning part, already explained, answer should be in black and white mode. No photo or color copy. No visual distraction such as stains, wrinkles, shades, overexposure, etc. Appropriate framed and position. No tilting, background exposure, fingers, etc. Samples for scanning. If you'll see few samples, here we can see this is not completely black and white mode and this red color is visible. So that's why we have to reject it. And if we'll reject overexposure and not readable, for example, in this case, this is not readable and backside page is also overexposed. So we have to reject this type of answer. Now we have to reject shades and other issues. For example, this answer is not properly cropped, right? And there is a overexposure of backside page. If you'll see this part, overexposure. So that's why we have to reject this type of answer. Next, if you'll see, we have rejection requirements. So this is the next point which we have to cover. To reject a solution, you have to meet the two requirements. First is the valid and specific reason and related screenshot of the wrong part. So if you are rejecting an answer, we have to attach the screenshot mentioning which part is wrong or which step is wrong. So valid and specific reason, and in this we'll see explanation. Rejection should be primarily based on the conceptual error. First we have to see the answer conceptually and then see on formatting error. If solutions are correct and easily readable, then avoid minor formatting errors. Examples of valid and specific reasons, we'll see few examples. For example, step 2 is beyond syllabus of grade 7 and please use a simple method. This may be the valid reason. Next, wrong answer, calculation mistake in line 8. It should be different result after multiply, or the word approximate in line 2 is incorrectly spelled. Similarly, if you'll see the second point, which is unacceptable reasons. Previously, we have seen acceptable, now unacceptable reasons. So we cannot directly write like this, wrong or incorrect answer. Follow the guidelines, poor handwriting, format issues and alignment issues. These are totally unacceptable. Now, if you see the screenshot with clearly labeled error. So to help understand, like producers will understand why you are rejecting their answers, then they can rectify their mistakes. And because of this, a proper screenshot with correctly mentioned reason is necessary. So if your rejection does not include a proper screenshot, the solution provider may report and request for appeal to referee. So acceptable screenshot will be reject reason. Like in this case, if you'll see, please find the 10th term from end. Here they have mentioned, they have attached the screenshot. Here 10th term is calculated from starting, but according to the question, he has to solve, producer has to find it from the end. So that's why this is valid. Now if you'll see some unacceptable screenshot, we'll see here the QC person has directly written some spelling are wrong and follow guidelines. This is totally unacceptable. Which spelling is wrong and what to follow in guidelines, they have to mention. Because here if you'll see, the answer is given to find solution and answer statement is also written. Now, in this case, the rejection reason is overwriting. But if you'll see the answer, there is no overwriting at all. Similarly, if you'll see here, for because of this small dot, please clear the background and then upload. This small dot can be neglected and can be easily passed. So we can ignore this type of small dot where it is not distracting the students and student can easily understand the solution, then we can ignore it. So our main aim is to about the end user. Our end user is the students. Now, next is the fourth point, which is anti-fraud and internal check, landmines and complaints. So please note that you shall avoid unnecessary rejections or all-time passes simply to increase your QC count. Decisions should be authentic if rejection shall contain valid and detailed reason along with error screenshot. So now we have also started the landmine solutions. These either correct or incorrect solutions we are posting. So are intentionally and randomly distributed to every quality inspector. Certain punishment will occur once the landmine solution are incorrectly passed or rejected. In both ways, we are going to ban them. So complaints may be lost by content producers if he or she consider your rejection unfair. An internal team will address the complaints and make final decisions. Following cases may make a valid complaint against quality inspector. For example, rejection without valid reason. Rejection requirement valid and specific reason is required. Rejection without screenshot. The decision made by referee is final. It will be referred as one of the evaluation indicators for quality inspector and will result in punishment and rewards. Now, the next point which we are going to see is the penalty part. This is the very important part. For any violation of these guidelines, different actions will be taken depending on how serious and negatively influential the case is. So based on landmine on trap questions and complaints results, suspension rule is as follows. So this suspension rules we have made total trap questions for wrong QC. Wrong QC means it should be incorrectly passed or incorrectly rejected in both way. Percentage explosion is 50%, greater than 50%, and this is the total suspension rule. So for 4 to 6 total wrong QC, and if you are lying in greater than 50% criteria, then there will be 24-hour suspension. So similarly, it will go up to 14-day suspension. Now, how we have calculated the percentage explosion? It is landmine explosion divided by landmine received. For example, if you have received 20 landmine questions and you have done wrong QC for 10 questions, then you are at 50%. So you have to focus about this part as well. So there will be payment deduction as well in future. Right now we are not deducting, but in future this is in plan, like we are going to deduct your payment as well. So note there will be suspension based on the referee final decision, and it is advisable to reject on answers only if rejection is valid and according to required standards. The regular action include but not limited to warning mail. We will send warning mail related to unusual activities. Then we can suspend your account up to 14 days, and there will be account revocation, and there will be no payment as well if you will find that if there is no improvement after warning and suspension. Now, if we'll go to the next point, which is frequently asked questions. So this is very important to clear all your doubts and confusions. What if I do if I encounter the following submissions? Multiple questions in one question stem image, incomplete question stem, diagram missing, key information missing, etc. Inverted question stems, question stems not the selected grades, language, subject, etc. Non-solvable question stems like a random picture, selfie, etc. So we generally recommend our producers not to attempt such type of questions. So you can also follow here. You have to reject these type of questions with corresponding reason. For example, if any question has many subparts, so if there is more than one question in any one question stem, so logically we have to skip those questions. So if any producer are answering those type of questions where there is a multiple subparts, so you will reject those answers saying that the producer has to skip those questions where there is a many subpart of the questions, right? Next, if there is an incomplete question, for example, here it is incomplete question because figure is missing. So you have to reject the answer if it is produced by the producer, and you have to write the exact reason. Similarly, if there is an inverted question stem, so you have to write or you have to reject those answers saying that user has to skip this as incomplete questions. Similarly, this is incomplete question and inverted question as well. You have to reject those answers. This is a non-solvable question. You have to reject. Similarly, this is incomplete question. You have to reject. Now, if you'll see the second point, what if the content producer disagree with my rejection? Will I be punished? So here, answer will be, when your QC rejection occurs, the submission will be returned to the original content producer, who may choose one of the following actions. So redo the work based on rejection reason, skip the task and take the new one, and complain against you. So lodge a complaint and report the case to the referee team. So please note that if the complaint is lodged against you, our internal referee team will look into it. This is our internal team, not an external team, and make a final decision based on standards. So if it's detected you are frequently complained against and decisions are negative to you, it may lead to punishment as well. So some submissions are not 100% strictly follow the rules. So shall it be qualified? This is the third question. Like strictly not followed. So should we consider it or should we not? So answer will be, although we require the submission meet the standards, it is understandable that the few parameter will need human judgment. We allow slight adjustment for the following parameters. So we can allow the slight judgment here. So here it will be, as long as rules are not obviously violated, for example, the left, right, horizontally, vertical alignment, uniform spacing, or ignorable dots. So if you'll see, like left, right, horizontal alignment or vertical alignment, this sample is not strictly followed, but answer is correct and student can easily understand those answers. So then we can ignore that and we can pass those type of answers. So it is important that in this question, it is not completely left aligned, but yes, we can pass this answer because student can easily understand this question. Next, we'll see the uniform spacing. So there are times like the uniform spacing is not maintained between two words or between the lines, but if student can understand those answers, so we can pass this. If the answer is correct, we can pass. Next, ignorable dots. For example, in this question, if you'll see, there are few ignorable dots here, this part, but there will be no issue with student. They can easily understand this. So our duty is to pass this type of answers. So I hope all these frequently asked questions will clear all your small doubts. And in future, we expect that you will follow all the guidelines and all the standard given by us. So thank you for listening this. Thank you.